إذن the word لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله is the greatest ذكر you're going to say when you're seeking Allah's help to continue in your worship and to defeat laziness. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says that the people use the word لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله incorrectly. They use it incorrectly. He said people use it when there's a disaster or a calamity they're facing. Something of trouble happened. لا حول ولا قوة إلا incorrect usage. When trouble happens, you say إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله is a ذكر you're supposed to say when you're feeling down, when you're feeling lazy, when the muadhin is saying come to salat, when you're being called to come to the goodness, when a fundraiser is being called and people are urged and encouraged to give money to worship. Say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah and engage in the worship. You will find that Allah Azza wa Jal, so Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will give you the ability. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he says that la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah babun min abwabil jannah. It's a door of the doors of the paradise. Meaning anyone who says it, it'll make the worship easy for him, and as a result, the door of the paradise opens for him. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله كنز من كنوز الجنة. That it is a treasure, a chest of the treasures of the paradise. What does that mean? That you know the entire paradise is a treasure. But when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that this word is a treasure in the paradise, meaning is it is a treasure compared to the treasure that's already in the paradise. And you understand something. Yani ma'anata, its reward is huge. That's what it means. That the reward of this word is so huge. It's a door of the paradise on its own for the one who continuously used to say it. وَكَنْزٌ مِنْ كُنُوزِ الْجَنَّةِ. You know, a kanz, a treasure box. What's in a treasure box? What's inside a treasure box? Money, gold. Valuable gold. It's already collected for you. You don't have to collect it. In other words, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. العلماء رحمهم الله, they said this one phrase collects a lot of meanings within it. When you say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, it affirms the fact that you are relying on Allah عز وجل. There's reliance of Allah inside this statement. When you say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, تدل على الافتقار إلى الله. It also implies that you are acknowledging your weakness before Allah Azza wa Jal. There's so many meanings within لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says in a hadith that لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله تحت العرش. It's underneath the عرش. طيب, I ask you a question. What's written on top of the عرش? Pay attention so you can learn something incredible in this. What's written on top of the arsh? Who knows? There's something written on top of the arsh. Allah wrote it and it's a book and He stored it on top of the arsh. It's a few words. Allah Azza wa Jal wrote, Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. That's on top of the arsh. It means Allah Azza wa Jal said, My mercy precedes my anger. My mercy overrides my anger. That's on top of the arsh. Underneath the arsh, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. What's the relationship between the two? On top of the arsh, Allah is teaching us how He deals with the servants. How He deals with us. He deals with us with mercy and compassion. And under the arsh, what is written is how we are supposed to deal with Allah. And that is that we cannot do anything except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and aid and support.